Joining me today at the Mecca of feeder fishing that is Bough Beech Reservoir. I'm here with Mick Vials and we're going to run you through everything you need to know about the new Absolute Window Feeders from Preston Innovations. We looked to design what we felt was the perfect window feeder, trying to get all the aspects absolutely bang right because this is such an important feeder in your feeder fishing. So, first of all, we're going to look at the size of the window here. We played around with the size of this. You needed to get it absolutely right. If it's too big, your bait was emptying too cleanly or too openly upon impact on the water. This way you get plenty of protection, but when you begin to wind back, the bait will flush out of the window. To help that happen, we've actually put a slight angle on the lead inside the feeder, so it's angled towards the window. So as the water pushes in the top, it flushes the bait cleanly out of the window right when you pick up, which is just what you need, so the bait will be there when you go in fishing next time. We've also put some nice large holes on the top of this window and made it a sort of torpedo shape. So what we found was, as you began to wind in, the water pushed in through the holes and flushed that bait out. But when you're winding back, the shape of the top meant it was a really good retrieve, really easy to retrieve, and that's really important, especially when you're fishing with any sort of feeder. It's also very important to keep the inside of the window feeder clean. No bars or anything in there that's going to stop it. We fix the swivel at the top and the whole thing is clean inside and it allows the bait to flush out neatly. The lead's nicely anodized just for a bit of inconspicuousness in clear water, different sizes, and that's really important as well. We also looked at the position of the holes against the window. We found just at the top of the window, again, just helped that bait push out really cleanly. That moves us on to the caged window. Now this is a really, really interesting concept for a feeder. It's the first that's been done and it's got the combination and everything that a window feeder offers you, but in a cage version as well. And we all know how good a cage feeder is. We've got the right size mesh in there, we've got the right shape of window feeder throughout. These Absolute window feeders are going to do everything you need them to do in your feeder fishing. Let's take this one here, the solid, more traditional window feeder, and go and see England international Mick Vials, and he can tell us all about how to use it.
Window feeders, in my opinion, are probably one of the most underestimated feeders on the market. And the reason I say that is because the anglers that have been on them for a long time, they understand what they do and the benefits of them. So the lads that fish in Ireland on the festivals and the people on the UK match circuit that fish these wild, natural venues, they understand. And the things what I want to explain to people are, there's a massive, massive benefit for anglers who are maybe just starting out in feeder fishing. One is the low diameter of a window feeder means that it can cast and it flies through the air a lot easier than most of the wider, bulkier, weight forward feeders. All the weight's at the bottom, nice and narrow, it literally goes like a bullet. Now the one that I've got in my hand here, this is the solid window feeder. We've already talked about the cage version, which has got all the mesh up the back, but this one is 90% solid plastic. And I look at this feeder in a different way to the cage one. If I want to feed worms or wet ground bait, live maggots as opposed to dead maggots. So if I were using the cage, I'd look at that for particles, corn, casters, that pellets, that sort of bait. But when I want to encapsulate all my bait and keep it really tight in deep venues, especially like the one that I'm here at Bough Beach, it's deep and it's windy and it's really, really wild. This is almost like a casket around your bait. It'll take it right down to the bottom. And I think that's one of the sort of underestimated benefits of these feeders, that regardless of what you do, when you cast it, all that bait is being held together until it gets right down to the very bottom. And for most anglers, I think that just gets away with some of the problems that they have with normal feeders, cage feeders, wide open feeders, that sort of release bait and keep your fish off the deck. These will take it right down to the bottom, which is of course where your hook is, and ultimately will allow you to catch a lot more fish.
So at Bough Beech today, I've approached it on two different lines. First of all, I've got the short line, which is, today it's about 18 meters, and then a longer line at around about 50 meters. Now, there's a massive difference in depth between those two lines. On the longer line, I've probably got about 35 feet of water, which is obviously really deep. And it definitely is an advantage to have solid winder feeder on that Mick's been using out in that deeper water. But I did use the cage at the start because I felt there was an advantage to have a little bit of bait breaking off to try and draw some fish from that incredible depth down to the bottom. But once I got fishing, I did find that this more solid feeder was better. Now, I'm back out on the long line now. And one of the things I've noticed is with these solid type feeders, you can actually load a lot of particles into them and then cap it off with ground bait. But one of the nice things about the cage style feeder, you can load it a little bit more traditionally like you would a normal cage. And by that I mean, you can actually mix your bait in with your ground bait and you can load the feeder with ground bait throughout. So you're getting the benefits of the winder feeder by being able to cast really accurately. But there you can see I've loaded the feeder with ground bait casters, bit of corn, all mixed together. And it's actually ground bait throughout. And I've nipped it in as it's falling, odd little bits of ground bait are gonna come out, creating that little column of bait. And then once it's on the bottom and the ground bait starts to break down, when I pick up to retrieve, the ground bait will flush in out of the holes. It's had a small indication there, got me a bit excited. But when I'm on shallower pegs, so for example, on the shorter line where I'm fishing today, I can actually load this feeder slightly differently. I can just gently scoop a little bit of ground bait in and give it a little touch. I know that it's a lot shallower closer in, say 6 or 7 feet. And the protection of the feeder means that most of the ground bait will probably have come out by the time I get to the bottom, which I really like. It creates that column throughout the water that fish can compete in. But because it's a window, it can cast really accurately, especially on these cross breezes, and they retrieve really nicely as well. So you can see why they'd be an advantage. I don't really want to be using the large feeder all the time. On that shorter line, I've opted for the smaller window. They come in three sizes, and in the smaller one, you can have 30 gram, 45 gram, 60 gram. There's a medium size, 45, 60 gram, and a large in 45 and 60 gram. And you need to decide what size is the best for you on the different lines. Here you can see I'm sitting and waiting a little bit, so I've opted for the bigger feeder, the feeder that is gonna take more bait down because the whole process takes a lot longer. But when I'm in and out working hard on shorter lines, that's when the smaller feeder comes into its own. So there's such a variety there. Oh, that's a bream. There's such a variety there of choices that you can decide and what to use. It gives you the complete option throughout. So I've had that in there, just looking at the stopwatch, probably about 5 minutes or so. And that's on the larger cage version. I just switched to the cage because I did feel I needed to bring some fish into the peg. I did feel it had gone a little bit dead, but that's a proper bite and a proper fish, and hopefully it'll find the net. They don't half pull hard on Bough Beech. Really wild fish, the water's really deep. You can see I'm being quite aggressive. I've got a big size 12 N30 hook on because I need to be aggressive. There's a lot of pike in here. I'm winding this fish up from 35 feet. I don't want to get it caught on the ledge. So this winder feeder is really helping because I don't really even know the feeder's on. I can wind through the feeder and just plain play the fish because of the shape and style of this feeder. Really, really nice, makes my fishing really easy. To be honest, on these natural venues where I'm fishing traditional feeders, these winder feeders are going to cover so much of my fishing. It's such an advantage to have. It's got him down to the net area. Here he is, look. Oh, he's a good one. Woohoo! Perfect. There you go. A really nice bream there. Well, not a nice looking bream, he's a bit skanky, but 4 or 5 pound fish on the cage winder feeder. What more could you possibly want? And just because you're using a window feeder, people sometimes associate those with more natural baits like worms and casters, but I like to think you can put anything or any bait you like into that feeder. So if I was gonna load this feeder with, say, corn, take some F1 corn here, for example, I've got some in here with a little bit of hemp, all I've got to do is just scoop that into the feeder, and I've got some corn there, in there, and I can scoop that in my pellets, and you can see there, the feeder is filled with pellets, an odd caster that snuck in, and some corn. And then this is the key to the bait. To hold this bait in, you just want literally a tiny bit of ground bait. So I just take it in the ground bait and just press gently with the window that's the perfect size for your thumb, and it just nips the ground bait across the window and allows that to be full of bait. So when that hits the bottom, this piece of ground bait breaks away over time, and then that allows the bait to be flushed out as you retrieve. So baits like corn and pellets are fantastic, but I've also got with me, of course, worms and casters. So you see here some casters and a bit of chopped worm, a few dead maggots. I've got a combination of baits, and by working those baits, I can figure out what's best for today. At the moment, I'd probably say the corn and pellets are outscoring most things, but it's always hard to tell. But I'd say that corn and pellets are working well, and they tend to go better with, to be honest, the cage is probably better for baits like corn and pellets, because if you put them in the cage, they're not going to come out on the way down, they'll only come out of the window, and the water can access it and flush it out. If you want maybe baits with more juice like worms and casters, the solid feed is probably going to be your choice. But as you can imagine, and as Mick has already alluded to, we know why we use a solid feeder, and I've talked to you about why you use a cage. But they're the sort of baits you'd probably use on a window feeder. I'm gonna get back out, see if I can catch another.
Fishing just shy of 60 metres, trying to catch the resident bream. I know they live here. It's a really good spot. Where I'm actually fishing here is sort of 30 foot deep. It's a 15 second count on a 40 gram bomb. Set off by attacking it quite positively. Fed a lot of pellets and corn. Very little live bait. There's a lot of perch in the venue at the minute. They're quite, you know, pests almost. Just trying to select a few bigger fish. Here's a skimmer. Slightly better fish. So I've started with pellets and corn. Not many maggots. Not many worms. Not many casters. They attract small roach, small skimmers. And especially the perch I've just mentioned, which there seems to have been an explosion. And that's a beautiful fish. Really healthy here, the fish. The water quality is fantastic. It's a big water. As I said, I've started at 60 metres and I've fed that really aggressively. But then what I've actually done is I've kept on putting pellets and corn, and to introduce them in such a depth and with the big wind and the distance, I've used a 60 gram window feeder. And when I've fed pellets and corn, I've used the new cage style because I want to make sure the water gets to those pellets and flushes it out. Now though, the fish seem to be here, so I've moved on to the solid. I've just crammed that full of worms, and the beauty of the solid over the cage is that you can squeeze them worms in tight, cap it off with ground bait. I'm just using Sonu 50-50, a match method, half and half. Just capped it off and I've got a bunch of maggots on the hook. The fish here, they're slow to come, but when they do come, they go down in the feed. You've got to be quite aggressive. Plenty of bait. Size 12, N30, new natural range hook to an 015 power line. Nice and positive. Get the bait down. Ignore the little taps and bangs. Work through the liners and catch the skimmers. So obviously we've got the fish feeding there. And as I said, we've been feeding pellets and corn. I've now moved on to worms, and that kind of causes me just to change up my feeder sizes. Now that I'm trying to get a lot of worms in there, I've actually dropped down to a medium. I started on a large, that'll carry lots of pellets and lots of corn. But of course, you know, you can get through tons of worms. So a medium will carry enough worms just to, you know, get you there. And when you don't want too much other bait, especially ground bait, you can drop down the sizes, even to a small, because that will carry, in the case of worms, loads and loads of bait. We do those, you know, from 30 gram right up to 60 gram. So depending on wind conditions, like at the minute, it's sort of, you know, it's medium, it's been a lot stronger than this. And I've had to use a 60 gram to get me to where I need to be. The most important thing, we're a long way from the bank, it's 60 meters. We need to make sure that we're hitting the spot. The fish are quite concentrated. And you need to make sure your bait is right in the middle of those fish. And by moving up a weight to feeder, that'll just make sure that you know your bait is where you need to be. You're fishing, you can sit back, watch the tip, and wait for a pull. Catch your bream.